from the 4th century all the way to 17th, 18th century. That anything scientific, philosophical, etc., you know, they can bring to life. Okay? They were persecuting scientists, philosophers, all that kind of stuff. And people who were caught, for example, reading the Greeks, okay, you're suspicious of evil and they will burn you alive. The Greeks were forbidden for more than 1,000 years. Which raised the question that how come later the West will claim origins in the Greeks when you have more than 1,000 years where nobody could read the Greeks? What kind of heritage from the Greeks you're taking? I don't know if you follow me here, but when you have all the generations of more than 1,000 years of people who didn't read the Greeks, who were forbidden by the church, and the period of Christian law, and all these obscurantism, how come people claim later that your origin is in a place and a tradition that you never follow up because you were persecuting the people who would be reading them seriously, okay? So how did the Greeks arrive to the West? Well, they arrived to the West, basically through Islamic philosophers, okay? That's how they arrived to the West. They were the ones taking very seriously Greek sciences, Greek philosophy, and all this stuff, okay? And doing the translation to Arabic, etc., and then, you know, continuing with the tradition of the Greeks and developing further, okay? And beyond the Greeks, okay? It's not, it was not just translation, it was more than that. It was a contribution to the push further these knowledges, you know, to another level, you know. So this, all these things are very history, you know, because the West will claim that origins is the Greek philosophers 5 centuries before Jesus, you know, that period of Plato, Aristotle, all that. When in fact, the Christian of Europe was really bearing that tradition and persecuting whoever followed, you know. Over a period of more than 1,000 years. So this is just nonsense when you start thinking about it. Of course, that invention of being having an origin in Greek civilization is an invention that has to do with the later modern period of inventing a narrative that would justify the racial superiority of the West over the rest. So you need to then claim an origin in something that they will give the West some kind of superiority over the rest. I would say, okay, the Greeks were part of Europe, and this is our origin, and so on, and then embed a narrative of history that will give them some kind of justification in the colonial expansion to claim that they are superior over the rest. That's why that invention happened in the 17th, 18th century. Okay? The invention of European origins in Greece. Okay? That's an invention of the colonial modern period as part of the narrative of creating a superiority of the West over the rest. Okay? You could see the work of Martin Murnau, okay, Black Athena, to document this discussion, those of you interested in that. Anyway, so what happened? So you have, I don't want to go into detail about, you know, the Prophet Muhammad and, you know, the message of Tawhid again, coming back, etc., you know, but to make a long story short, because we can go in a long, you know, conversation about that, but make a long story short, in the 8th century of Christian era, okay, 8th century, you have the arrival of the Muslims to this part that, you know, is we know as the Iberian Peninsula, okay? There is another mythology of the West is to say that there was a Muslim Arab conquest of Spain, okay? And therefore, all the narrative about the Christian forces taking over Muslim land in the Iberian Peninsula is conceived as a reconquest. That RE there has to do with this idea that the Muslims took this away from us and now we are reconquering it. Okay? this is the narrative that you get in Eurocentric narrative of history. And unfortunately, because we have been colonized by those narratives, you could hear Muslims repeating it, okay? Unfortunately, saying that, you know, there are Muslim conquests of Spain, and you know, and using this language. And I'm always saying, medieval Islam. What? Medieval Islam? What do you mean? Oh yes, the feudal era, medieval times, well, this is a time history of that the West invented in the 17th century. There was no medieval Islam. Feudalism never was in outside Europe. Feudalism was a European phenomenon. It doesn't exist anywhere else. Why do we use this time frame in history? We've been colonized by that too. We use that time frame because the West invented this linear history from the Greeks to the Romans. From the Romans, they jumped to the Renaissance in the invention of the origin in the Greek civilization. Then they jumped from the Greek, from the Roman, all the way to the Renaissance. There's a 1,000 years there, they don't document. Okay, what is this 1,000 years? Middle Ages. All of these are made, then from the Renaissance to the Enlightenment, no? And the Enlightenment to positivism and so on, okay? But what happened with these 1,000 years between the fall of the Roman Empire and the Renaissance? Middle Ages? Why doesn't it have a name? It has a name, it's called Islamic Renaissance. That's what it's called. That's how philosophy, sciences, knowledge came to this part of the world. We call it Europe today. That's how they arrived. It should be called Islamic Renaissance. We cannot say that because in the invention of this narrative, linear history, in that invention of the 17th, 18th century, if they recognized that they got modern sciences from, or philosophy, or Greek philosophy, all that stuff, from Islamic civilization, then the whole narrative of the superiority of the West over the West falls apart. Follow me here? Is this clear? I mean, if you recognize that you're indebted to Islamic civilization in the structure of knowledge production, then the narrative of the invention of this linear history, okay, it falls apart because they do have to recognize it then, okay, with someone else, and therefore you cannot claim you're superior over the rest. As simple as that, you see? So how do you claim you're superior over the rest? You bury this period, you call it Middle Ages. And this is a time frame, antiquity, Middle Ages, modernity. And then they try to subsume where history came to this time, linear time frame. That is, they have colonized our sense of time in history. And now you open books of Islamic history written by Muslims saying Middle Age Islam. You say, what? There was no Middle Ages in Islam. There was no, you know, the West call it Dark Ages, Middle Ages. Do you remember that? There was no Middle Ages, there was no feudalism in Islam or anywhere else except in Europe. You know, and this time frame had nothing to do with the history of Islamic civilization, Chinese civilization, or any other civilization around the world. This is an invention of the West that, as part of the colonial project, has put it on their heads, and now they repeat these things as common sense. And now we talk about medieval Islam, I mean, or medieval China, or medieval, I mean, what is this? This is nonsense, absolute nonsense. That's a way they have colonized concept of time and concept of space. They have colonized this in our common sense today. We repeat it as common sense. We don't take a step back to say, where is this? What are we saying? You know, where is this coming from? Oh, this is a recent invention, 17th, 18th century. I didn't see it before. Not even in what we call the West. Okay? So the question is that when the Muslims arrive to the Iberian Peninsula, I was saying that there was no invasion or no conquest. How this happened? First, Spain did not exist. So if there was a conquest, it was not against Spain. Because Spain did not exist in the 8th century. What existed was a Visigoth, despotic structure of power in alliance with the Christian non-church, okay, the people in the Middle Peninsula. Who were these people? They were Unitarian Christians, Jewish people, indigenous people from there. So all these people are being oppressed by the Visigoths. Had nothing to do with Spain. Okay? And these people went and crossed the Mediterranean and went to Muslim land asking for solidarity. Asking for, we need help here, because they saw, for example, to give you an example, the Jews were comparing themselves with the Visigoths and other Muslim political authority. And the Jews were seeing, you know, with the tax of the Muslims on the other side, short of the Mediterraneans, were much lower than what we're getting taxed here. Okay? So they went there and said, we need help. And you have Unitarian Christian Jews, and indigenous people from there asking for help. So